Well, our Foreign Affairs Chief Rob Parsons is covering this story for us today, and he's on the line now. Rob, first of all, what do we know about what is actually happening at the border at the moment?
Well, you know, if you listen to the Republicans, the situation is catastrophic at the moment with people pouring across the border. The reality isn't really quite as bad as that. You know, some things have changed under Joe Biden regarding migrants coming across the southern border, in particularly, as you mentioned just now, towards undocumented children. And as a consequence of what Joe Biden would call his more compassionate approach to letting in undocumented children, there are now 15,000 children staying in federal custody, in accommodation which is clearly not designed for them, which is becoming increasingly an embarrassment for this administration. But when it comes to the more sort of general picture, although Joe Biden has said he's given the order to stop building the wall, which was such a signature aspect of Donald Trump's policy towards migration from the South, there isn't a great deal that's changed. But the important thing I think here is that this is an opportunity for the Republicans to suddenly start hitting Joe Biden after a couple of months in which they found it really difficult to land a punch on him. Joe Biden says he's going to go to the southern border to see for himself, to convey the idea that, you know, he's on top of things, that he regards it as a matter of urgency. But there's no doubt that for the first time, really, since he took office, he's really under pressure.
Yeah, and just how serious, at least the political challenge, do you think this presents for Biden and for his administration?
Well, you know, Joe Biden clearly, as I just said, he's under pressure and he has to act. The problem for him, I think, is that, you know, he wants to create this impression of being much more compassionate than his predecessor. But at the same time, he wants to avoid the impression that he's naive. So what he's saying, I think, is, look, you know, we're prepared to let young children cross the border, help them find their families. If we can't find the families, help them find sponsors in the United States. But as for the rest, the situation will remain pretty much as it has been until a new policy, what Joe Biden called guardrails, are put in place to make sure it doesn't become chaotic. In addition to that, Biden is saying, look, you know, this isn't anything to do with me being overcompassionate. This is all to do with the situation that's developed, partly as a consequence of Donald Trump's policies, destroying the infrastructure for dealing with migrants coming across the border, but also the situation in Central America and Mexico, particularly Central America, which has suffered very badly from COVID-19. Unemployment has gone much higher as a consequence, and as a consequence of climate-related events. A couple of major hurricanes have really hit the economies of Central American countries very badly. As a consequence, there's been a spike in the number of people trying to get up to the border with the United States. So what he's saying is we need to think long-term about what we can do about investing in those countries so that they become more stable, so that the need to migrate elsewhere, particularly in the United States, obviously, is reduced.
Rob Parsons, thank you very much indeed.